The book of Romans has sections. You see that in the beginning, the law of Moses demanded righteousness from men. And there was no single human being who was righteous. Then the book of Romans comes to tell you that which the law of Moses was demanding was made manifest through the person of Christ Jesus. So Christ is the manifestation of the righteousness of God. Then the book of Romans comes to tell you this righteousness that the law of Moses was demanding, that was manifested or revealed through Christ Jesus, this same righteousness can be received by anyone who believes. That's why Romans chapter 1 verse 17 says, for in the gospel, which means if there is a gospel that does not reveal the righteousness of God, then that's not a gospel at all. Every person who's saying is a preacher of the gospel must reveal, for in it the righteousness of God is revealed. The gospel reveals the righteousness of God that is being demanded by the law. The law of Moses demands. The gospel reveals. Praise be to God. Then after it's revealed, then now the righteousness of God can be received by a believer. For he made him who knew no sin be sin for us, that he might become the righteousness of God through Christ Jesus. So you have received the righteousness of God by believing. So the righteousness of God, first of all, is demanded. Then through Christ Jesus, it is revealed. Then by believing in the gospel, can be received, demanded, revealed, and received. Is that the end? No. The righteousness of God must be reproduced. It must be reproduced. So I know all of us who are sitting here, we have known what the law demands. It was impossible. No single human being could achieve it. It was revealed through Christ Jesus. We believed and we received it. It is now time to reproduce it. Praise be to God.